Hello my fellow Minecraft fans and welcome to another video. And today we're going to be actually going over how to make a house in Minecraft. And it is surprising how many people don't really know how to make a good house or a decent looking house. And I would definitely count myself among them when I first started out. Now, my first house looked something like that, only probably worse. And then it looked like that after a creeper blew it up. So yeah. My first Minecraft world that I ever created, I didn't actually get a house, but we don't talk about that. Anyways, I'm going to make this as simple as possible because it is kind of a broad topic. And so, as you can see, I have two houses over here. We don't count that crater now. That is irrelevant. And also, I will put a timestamp up in case you want to skip the intermediate house and go straight to the super advanced house. But anyways, now moving on from that, let's start out with the first house. And I'm going to go over all of the little tips and tricks and design features that I included in this. So I started out just by including a stone brick foundation. And it's often nice to have the first layer just wrap around being a stone block, depending on what kind of house you're building, because it looks nice as a foundation, as you can see here. And then staying on the outside, as you can see, I have the stripped oak logs running around it on top of the bricks. And that sort of also provides some more contrast, something to look at, because having houses that are all one block with no depth really just don't look as good as they could. Now, this is not gonna look as good as that because this is the intermediate house. It's not that hard to build. And as you can see, using the new wall mechanics in 1.16, we are able to actually make a really nice transition from the window to back to the actual wood. And also, having big windows like this, it's not a bad idea to put some stairs or something to create sort of like a little window ledge, and that can often look really nice. It's all about having contrast, visual details, things that draw your eye away from just like a plain wall of the same thing. Like over here, it's getting a little bit just into the same block with no variation or texture. But that's why it's the intermediate house. Also, lanterns look really nice regardless of how you use them. They're just hard to make them not look nice. And moving on to the interior, there are a lot of small interior decoration details that I have in here. Let's start from the top down. So as you can see, we just have a loft in here. It's not a full second story. And I tried to use different types of wood. As you can see, we have birch like fence here. We have just various oak pieces, and then the predominant spruce roof. So having multiple different types of wood just used sparingly throughout the build can look really nice and add that little bit of just extra flair, I guess I would call it. And then we just have a stair block that is sort of inverted to make it look like a table with like a cup or something that's actually just a flower pot on top. And over here, this is a trick I learned recently, and it is using a loom, but with the back texture, because if you look, three sides of it are this almost cupboard or like empty bookshelf looking texture, and then there's just the one side that's actually the loom. So you can use this to make really nice sort of dressers or cupboards, and you can even cover up that part by using carpet on it. Yeah, there's a lot of little ways you can use that to make it look nice. And of course, we made use of the chain block coming down because that is such a nice looking block. If you include a little bit of carpet right after the doorway, it can kind of look like entryway rugs or mats or stuff that a lot of houses have. My actual house, like the house I live in real life, does have that, so that's kind of why I added that. And then if you add like little just floor carpets, not like wall to wall, because then there's no point in having the wood floor, but if you just have some carpet sparingly, it can look really nice. It can look like a rug or a living room carpet, that kind of thing. And so there's just a chair that is a stair block with item frames attached to the sides to add arms to it. And this lighting over here is just shroom light with trap doors placed on it, and it looks kind of cool set into the wall. Provides some nice lighting. And this is just a very simple chair and table setup, just using stairs and a fence with a pressure plate on top of it. A lot of these actually occur in villager houses, or at least they used to. I'm not sure if they still do. And moving on to the kitchen, using just a couple smooth stone blocks can really look like a nice butcher block counter. We also have a sink over here, and there are more ways you can make the sink look better. but I couldn't attach them to the wall or the pane, and there was no good way to squeeze that in. We have, like, what is that even called? Like, the fan that's above, like, stuff? Like, the fan that's above stoves and things like that, with, like, a chimney going out, and that is actually, if you look outside, that is just this up here. And this is a very simple chimney design, which is just a campfire surrounded by some trap doors so that you just see the smoke coming out, and it looks pretty nice. You probably noticed that the floor doesn't just include spruce planks, but it also includes stripped spruce logs placed at various different, like, directions, so it kind of looks worn down or weathered. In some places, that's just a nice way to add some more contrast and visual detail to the floor of your house. This landscaping, technically not part of building a house, but if you landscape around the house, even just a little bit like I did, it can add so much more to the build. And I used a path design that consists of three different types of blocks. It's gravel, cobblestone, and then it is actually basalt with the top facing upward, because it just looks like a darker cobble and it adds more contrast. In terms of putting leaves and bushes, you can just sort of, it depends on how much you want. These are quite simple bushes where it's often just a couple leaf blocks just stuck around to create small bushes and shrubs. And if you put coarse dirt, like, mixed in with the grass surrounding your path, it can look really nice. It can look sort of like it's landscape, or just the dirt is different under the shrubs. Because often in real life, there's not, like, grass that is underneath bushes and stuff like that. And so that's sort of what that looks like. And then we also have some flowers mixed in here. In this case, it is the alliums or something like that. I probably mispronounced that. I don't really know. Also, using two different types of leaf block in your shrubs and trees and, like, anything custom involving leaves often looks really nice. In this case, it's oak and birch, which look really nice when combined together. And see, it sort of just wraps around the side of the house. Also, out here we have the back door, which is just a simple path consisting of some coarse dirt and soul sand. Soul sand actually looks kind of like mud when you mix it in with dirt, so that's kind of what I was going for, or just like wetter areas of the soil, I guess. In survival, this house isn't that hard to build. Honestly, the interior is probably harder to decorate and actually build than the exterior. And the resources, it's not that bad, it just needs a bunch of wood and stuff, so. Alright, this is the third tier of house that I've constructed. This is a more medieval style house than that. That's kind of semi-modern, at least not medieval, let's just say. Now, you'll notice it has the same type of path using the three same different blocks in similar configurations. Also, on the exterior, it uses flowers, just a different type, uses cornflowers instead. And we still have the coarse dirt mixed in. We have the different types of leaf blocks as hedges. And they do extend most of the way around the house. But also over here is a different feature. Now, this part of the house when I was building it was sort of hanging over the cliff a little bit. It was like floating. So I decided to do a little bit of terraforming and just terraform in a nice dirt cliff here. All right, so to start off with, I think the most basic, the basic part of this build is that it actually comes out a block on the two sides, on this side and this side. It does not do that here, but the second floor actually comes out a full block from the bottom floor, which adds more depth and detail. However, these pillars are just like supports or whatever, like these pillars made out of the spruce logs are actually consistent with the top floor, which means that you can add depth to the bottom floor, if that kind of makes sense. It does sound confusing, but like, which leaves room to decorate the bottom floor with various things like stairs and slabs and fences. However, this is not true on the two ends, as I just decided to leave it like that, and I think it looks pretty good. In terms of the bottom block palette, I just used stone bricks, cobblestone, cracked stone bricks, and mossy stone bricks. And my reasoning with the mossy stone bricks was that if we go around the full edge of this, you'll notice that they are only on the very bottom block. And I did that because, and it just to me, it kind of makes sense that the moss wouldn't really go that high up the wall. And I just kept it like right at the bottom block. I think that looks nice. It kind of makes sense. A lot of people just default to using the standard glass that is like just normal clear glass. But I found and it's kind of a semi-common technique, is that just instead of using just plain old glass, like you can always just use a glass pane and it'll look okay. It's definitely kind of easier to see through, but in terms of actually looking nice, using a stained glass pane or just stained glass in general actually makes it look a lot more unique. Like here I used white stained glass, and up here I used gray stained glass. And gray stained glass honestly looks a little bit more like real glass, at least in my opinion. And it's sort of, depending on what kind of build you're doing, if you're doing a modern build, like really modern, then just using normal glass might be better. But especially in medieval, using light gray stained glass or white or gray stained glass really tends to look better in my opinion. Even over here, this is actually, I think this is light gray stained glass. Yeah, that is not even normal glass over there. We do use the new wall mechanics in 1.16 because I am playing on Snapshot 20W19A. We used the new wall mechanics to accent the windows, and I was trying to figure out if it would look good either on the sides or on the bottom, and I decided that it looks better on the bottom, especially because there's often less room on the sides, like in the front here. Then you don't really get to have blocks, which means that you can't have contrast, because you probably noticed that I didn't just straight up make the walls diorite, I made them diorite plus polished diorite. And often when you use two blocks of the same variety but just different textures, it often can look way better than just one flat, it's just surface of the same type of block. If this were just diorite, it would look really bad, because diorite doesn't look that good by itself. If it were just polished diorite, it would look better, but still not as good as it does when you combine the two. Here we have just a simple arch that goes above the window, and it looks really nice. It breaks up the wall, it makes there so that there's more stuff, more visual interest, as opposed to just a big flat wall. Because I was kind of going for medieval style, I decided to make the roof slope outward in addition to up. And that's somewhat common in medieval stuff or just like Viking related things. And so I just did a small slope outward. It goes a total of 3 blocks out over the course of like 6 blocks up or something. And I did use Blackstone, one of the new blocks from 1.16, because it looks so nice, or at least in my opinion, as like a shingle block kind of. And I decided to actually mix in some blue terracotta, and I think it makes it look so much nicer. I also put some gray carpet on top, just randomly spaced out, and it looks really cool in my opinion. It's the first time I've actually mixed these two blocks or 3 blocks together, and I am happy with the result. Now moving on to the interior, we just sort of have a simple shelf for barrels, and if you want them to be like just various barrels with like liquids or wine or water or whatever, you can add tripwire hooks and it looks like spouts. So that's what I did here. Scaffolding can look really interesting as a table, and you can even put just like carpet above it to hide that just grid pattern, and then that looks pretty nice as a table. Also, we have a bookshelf area with loom textures used to look like the bookshelves are empty in places, and we have another drawer area with just like a painting and stuff. Up here we actually just have stripped jungle logs and then oak planks. And the jungle is really close to the oak, but it's just a slightly different texture, so I kind of thought that would look cool. And it looks pretty decent. It might be a little dark in here. I do actually have the brightness set to moody because it looks better with smooth lighting. But there's a chance that mobs could spawn in here, although the darkest area also has carpet, so that might also negate that. This is just a simple, just like a double bed, and then this is one of several ways you can make just larger potted plants. You can either have like a cauldron, or you can put a fence underneath it. So if we were to go like, let me actually save the cauldron. As you can see, that also looks pretty good. If you put that in like dirt and make it even higher, that looks nice, because that actually looks like a stem, but cauldron is what I went for here for that simple plant design. I just kind of tried to make like some furniture. If you put stair blocks and you make them sort of face into each other and have corners like this, it looks a lot like a couch. That is a useful trick for making couches. And we have another kitchen, which is pretty similar to the one over there. But as you can see, I was actually able to have a place to put in the second part of the sink, which is either a lever or a tripwire hook. And that looks a lot like a faucet. Also, if you're wondering, that water is there thanks to water logging. So we couldn't do that before 1.13. Obviously, that's a while ago, but still, it's a nice feature that you can use now. We just have also a cake here, some barrels that kind of look like cupboards, and they actually act like cupboards. You can put stuff in them. Anyways, that's basically about it on the interior. I did actually include more strip jungle logs facing just like vertically like that to sort of make a trim around the top. And I think that looks pretty good instead of just including more diorite. And yeah, as you can see here, this lighting on the exterior looks really nice when it becomes night. It looks better than that because, well, I didn't include as much exterior lighting and this had a lot more opportunities to do that. And especially because I actually lit up the area that is light and like is the white blocks. So that even makes it kind of, it looks like it glows a little bit. But I think that is going to probably be it for this video. If you have enjoyed this video and found it informative and helpful, or want me to do more in-depth breakdowns of me actually building some of the stuff, or just more videos like this in the future, be sure to subscribe and comment down below so that I know that you're interested in that. Also, be sure to hit that like button if you enjoyed. And also, I do have a second channel that I just started where I'm actually going to be posting all of my LEGO related videos instead of on my main channel. So if you're interested in that, be sure to go over there, check that out. Link will be down in the description. But anyways, I will see you guys next time. Bye.